In breaking news tonight, the St Kilda Football Club has sacked star player Jason Graham. Melanie Davies joins us live from Melbourne with the details. Mel, what's the club's reasons?
Well, good evening, Hermione. The club has outlined the reasons why it sacked 28-year-old Jason Graham in a statement released just a short time ago. It came just a few hours after the 28-year-old appeared in a Moorabbin magistrate's court, but for legal reasons, unfortunately, we cannot say what charges he faces. The statement says the club has been working with Graham for a number of months on this issue in an attempt to ensure his behaviour appropriately reflected the values shared across the club and to assist with the management of his personal welfare. The statement goes on to say Graham was suspended from the club on September 6, but the decision to sack him wasn't made until yesterday after he was arrested here in Melbourne. The 28-year-old spent the night behind bars and was in a hearing in court this afternoon. In court, it appeared as though he was fighting back tears. His face was buried in his hands with his head between his legs. His manager was also in court and told the magistrate that last night was a massive wake-up call. It certainly has been, though, a tumultuous 24 hours for Jason Graham. He's been arrested, charged, released on bail and dumped by the St Kilda Football Club. He's due to reappear in court on November 22nd.
Thank you for the update. Melanie Davies in Melbourne. Well, if you haven't checked your OzLotto ticket yet tonight, we can break the news that you're not $70 million richer. Anthony Donaghy is in Brisbane tonight. Anthony, with no Division 1 winner, what will it jackpot to next week?
Well, Hermione, you have a very disappointed journalist and my cameraman, Gary. We both had tickets in tonight's lotto and we didn't pick up a cent. But the good news is it will be its ninth consecutive week, so that it will roll over and jackpot to $100 million on Tuesday. Now, that will be Melbourne Cup Day, so if you're lucky enough to pick the winner in the race, you'll have some spare cash to buy some more tickets. Now, there were some winners tonight. Close to 2 million Aussies won from Divisions 2 to 7, sharing in about a $40 million pool. So with 1 in 3 Aussies buying a ticket in tonight's draw, they expect that number to grow next Tuesday. But the mathematicians say the odds are against you. If you were to place a tissue box on the road from Brisbane to Sydney, you would need to pick the one box that has tissues. Now, I don't like to say it, but you have to be in it to win it.
Absolutely. Thank you, Anthony Donaghy in Brisbane. The government plans to remove the entire Australian mainland from the migration zone in a desperate bid to stop asylum boats. In 2006, John Howard tried to introduce the same legislation. Labor fought it furiously, calling it ludicrous and harsh, and won.
On our national character.
These are difficult decisions for everybody, but we do need to have in place a properly integrated system.
It's a major backflip that Labor justifies by pointing out that it's one of the recommendations in the Houston Review. The head of Virgin Airlines says its takeover of Tiger Airways is a win for passengers. Virgin Australia is buying 60% of the budget airline and also acquiring regional carrier SkyWest.
Competition will come to every segment of the market in Australia. That is good for jobs. It's certainly good for tourism.
Virgin predicts the increased competition could drive down domestic airfares by up to 30%. Police have questioned tennis star Bernard Tomic over an incident at his 20th birthday party. Officers were called to a Surfers Paradise hotel after a witness thought Tomic was strangling a man in a spa. But the police soon established they were only play fighting. It's bad timing for Tomic, who'll face court next Monday over a string of driving charges, which he plans to contest. The country's highest hospital helipad will be up and running by the end of the week. The 1,200-tonne concrete structure at Sydney's Royal North Shore Hospital will even be able to take army helicopters. Final test runs showcased how medical teams can take patients straight from the chopper, down a lift and into the emergency department in just 30 seconds. A washing machine and a chocolate bar have been named and shamed in this year's Shonkies. The awards by consumer group Choice have exposed a Samsung washer which uses more than 220 litres of water to clean 3 kilos of clothes, and Toblerone chocolate bars which claim to have 16 pieces but only have 15.
It may not necessarily be putting anyone in danger, but it's frustrating and it's just stupid. It's shonking.
Ticketek and Ticketmaster were also named for hefty fees. And there have been emotional farewells in Brisbane with the deployment of personnel bound for Afghanistan. The Amberley-based servicemen will take charge of security at the Tarancot Air Base. It's the largest Air Force contingent of its type since East Timor in 2006.
Come Wednesday, so he came a week early. He wasn't due for a week, so no, it was real good.
His timing's impeccable.
Yeah, it's like he knew it was coming.
They're taking over from a departing Slovakian force. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 25 degrees in Townsville, 19 in Brisbane and Sydney, 25 degrees in Melbourne, also in Adelaide, and 18 in Perth.